got everything packed up. I need to get one thing before I leave Destin, and then I'll be on my way to Miami. To explain a little bit about why I'm doing this trip. Well, first of all, I'll explain what this trip is. The point of the trip is I wanted to drive the whole length of the United States East Coast. And so the closest interstate to that is I-95, and a lot of I-95 is like literally like less than a mile away from the beach. Usually the whole time, and most of the cities that I'm going to, such as like Savannah and Fort Lauderdale and Washington DC and New York and Boston and even into Maine, I-95 goes straight through the middle of those. So that's basically what I wanted this trip to be, is I wanted to drive the whole length of the East Coast. I got this idea from Wade's friend Chase Lyons. He did a similar road trip to this last summer when he drove all around the United States. He drove like a big lap around of it. So I got a lot of ideas about how to sleep in my car, how to have food, how to store things. I got a lot of that stuff from him. And I graduated last Saturday. Today, right now it's Monday morning. I graduated last Saturday night. Congratulations. And I really wanted to do this trip right at the beginning of summer so that I could still have time the rest of summer to work in my summer job, so I could save up money for college this fall. My first stop was Destin. Now I'm going to Key West. Then I'm going to Savannah, Georgia, Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, New York City, Boston, Kennebunkport, Maine, Freeport, Maine, Ottawa, Montreal, Toronto, Detroit, Indianapolis, and I'm coming back home. But like I said earlier, the point of the trip was to drive the whole East Coast of the United States. And that's true, but once I saw how long the road trip back to home would be from Maine, it was gonna be like an 18-hour drive to get from Maine back to home. And so that just sounded miserable. That was like 2 days of just driving. I didn't go through the shortest route. It had me going through no major cities at all. So I really tried to break that up, and that's why I'm going into Canada and then coming back around, because each of those cities are less than 4 hours from each other, so it would really break it up, and I could get out of my car and experience some more cities. But all in all, this trip would take about 15 days. I've been driving through Florida for about 3 hours now, and I've come to the conclusion that Florida just sucks. Like, there's nothing here. It's just trees on both sides of the interstate.
For just, that's all it is. Like, I can see through the trees, and it's just more trees.
Like, it's just swampland, and it's just interstate that goes on in a straight direction just forever. I've been looking at the same thing for 3 hours now. Florida,
whoa, something is happening. I'm on a bridge. This is the first time I'm seeing anything besides just interstate and trees all day.
Cool.
Well, I guess that's it. Back to just staring at trees.
Just had lunch here at a new elegant five-star restaurant here in the middle of nowhere.
Back on the road again. I just turned on to I-75, which is the interstate that goes right through the middle of Florida. It's about 1:30, have about 5 hours left till I get to Miami. So it did look like I was gonna get there at about 5, but something changed and now it looks like I'm gonna get there at about 6:30. But that's okay. So I feel like I've been in Miami for like an hour now because I've just been on this freeway. It looks like you're about to enter the city, but you end up just keep being on a freeway. But I just exited the interstate and I still don't know if I'm in Miami. I mean, on the map it says I am, but this just looks like outskirts, even though it says I'm like downtown. So who knows? But maybe, yeah, it still says I have a mile, so maybe something will change in the next mile, but so far, looks like Miami just looks like the rest of Florida, and Florida sucks. So, that's what I think of Miami. I just figured out why everything looks so, ghetto. Just because Miami on mainland, like on the mainland, is all just like suburbs and stuff. But once you go to like South Beach, apparently that's an island. I don't know what it's called, but that's where South Beach is. That's where like all the skyscrapers and stuff are, and you can see those like in the distance. So that's where I'm going now because that seems like a more like a richer part of town. Should be pretty safe, and that's just all I'm looking for at this point. So. Alright, it took me forever, but I finally found a safe parking spot. I'm just fingers crossed that nobody's gonna tap on my window tonight and ask me to move because I have no idea where else I'll go. But I never did get any dinner, and I don't really want to lose the parking spot that I have because it's on like a side street and somebody could easily just come and take it. And there's nowhere around here to bike to. So, might just have cereal for dinner. But right now, I'm just sitting out looking at the water right now. Don't really know where I am. Just know I'm in Miami. And just looking forward to tomorrow when I go to Key West. That should be a lot better. This should be the worst city because all the other major cities, I have somewhere to stay in. So, fingers crossed. Yeah, I left that place. It's about 9:30. I just had a really bad feeling about where I was. So I'm going back. I'm not back. I'm going more south. There's a Walmart down there, and hopefully there'll be some more people around, you know, more witnesses if anything happens. So yeah, where I was in this like neighborhood. And, there's like people walking on the sidewalk and stuff, and it was really bad. So, I'm about 30 minutes away. I'll get there at about 10 o'clock. Hopefully, it'll be in a nicer part of town. This was a nice part of town, but I just had a bad feeling. Summer nights, love them.